Hello everyone, it's Nicolas from Autochroma. Today I represent you BRAW Studio, our new plugin for Premiere on Windows. So first I will present you the plugin and what we can do with it. In the second time I will show you how to install it, and at the end what's next for the future. So first, what is BRAW Studio? Blackmagic has launched his new RAW format called Blackmagic RAW. The problem is, for now, you cannot import them, this file, on Premiere. But with BRAW Studio, you will be able to do that, and you will be able to edit the RAW parameters. So, let's import some BRAW files. You can do this by double-clicking on the project panel there, and select your BRAW file. Or you can also go to Major Browser, right-click, and Import. So now I have three BRAW files and I want to access the RAW parameters. You can go to editing panel, you can double click on a clip and you will access the RAW parameters. You can also put a clip on a timeline like this. At left there, you have a tab, and in this tab, you will access also the RAW parameters. So now let's discuss about the different parameters. The first one is decode using. Initially, it's always on camera metadata and it represents the internal BRAW parameters. But you can edit all the parameters by going to clip. BRAW default will be just default parameters. Color science and color space have for now just one choice. There is ISO you can set, exposure, parameters about white balance and about gamma. For the white balance, we have a preset. You can see what values are associated with which preset. If I set a particular value on, for example, color temp, 10,000, it will automatically set custom. For gamma, it's a bit the same with sort of preset. With video, you will not be able to set gamma control. With custom, it's your parameters, and extended video and film are some sort of presets. At the end, you have two buttons. If I click on Save Sidecar, it will save all the parameters there to a file called Sidecar. If I change now some parameters like exposure and contrast, for example, and I want to get back to the last time I saved the sidecar, I can load the sidecar. My parameters will reset to the previous state. So just a little thing for the end. The RAW parameters are for a clip on the project. If I have two items on the timeline that have the same source, and if I go there, for example, and set 5 on the exposure, okay, it will be set for this item and this item because they have the same source clip. So if I want to get the same video but with different RAW parameters, I can import a second time the video and I will get two way of decoding the RAW file. So now let's see how to install BRAW Studio. After downloading the zip from the internet, unzip it and go to the folder. There are two choices to install BRAW Studio, and we recommend the first. The first is just to double click on the exe file and follow the steps, next, next, next. Here there are some options for After Codecs. It's another plugin that we sell with Autochroma. But if you have only license for BRAW Studio, After Codecs will be in trial mode. After that, there is this folder, Media Core. It's an Adobe folder. If you have installed Adobe regularly, it will be this one. So you will be able to click on Install and it will be finished. The other choice you get, it's just to copy this folder. Go to the Media Core folder, like this, in Program Files, Adobe Command Plugins 7.0 and Media Core, and paste the folder there. So now let's go in Premiere. Now your plugin is in trial mode and we have to enter the license. So import any BRAW file you get, for example this one, and access to the BRAW Studio source things. There is a little button on the right, click on it, and you will be able to enter the license here. You can get it from aescripts.com. On My Download and Licenses, you will be able to see your license. So copy it and enter it there. Activate license and it will say OK if it's good. OK, and now you will be able to get the full plugin. So now what next for the future? First, Blackmagic has launched a new version of its API. So in the next version of BRAW Studio, you will get more parameters like black level on the slider, white level, and many other things. Secondly, we will try to make a version of BRAW Studio available on OS X. And after that, we want to make BRAW Studio for After Effects and Media Encoder. If you get any trouble by using BRAW Studio, you can send us some logs by clicking on this checkbox on the setup button. Click OK. It will write some logs. You can find the log file here by clicking on the log folder. And you will have to send us these files by zipping them. So, thanks for watching and see you next time, guys.